So around 40 students are there. I think we can start. So good morning, students. So in the last class, we have seen that how we can construct the lambda by 2 and lambda by 4 resonators from the concept of the transmission line. So due to the some technical problem, actually I was unable to complete. So today we'll complete. I also thought that time that I'll record the lecture and I'll upload. But this is somewhat very important actually, and we're supposed to discuss. That is why only half lecture I uploaded over the YouTube. Correct. And today we'll complete and I'll try to upload. Fine. So I hope you are getting my voice clearly.
Yes, sir.
You are very tired, I think. No? Okay. So So it was discussed that ZIS is equal Z naught 10 hyperbolic alpha L, correct? And particularly we can also say Z naught over alpha L if alpha L is very very small, correct? So it is tending to infinity, but not actually. I would say this is tending to infinity, it is large. Better to say this is large value, correct? It will show a large value. So indirectly this thanks tells that we are particularly here doing for the parallel resonance case, correct? What we studied in circuit theory, correct? So if you recall that frequency response just a minute. This is the frequency response, and let's say this value is IM R, correct? And these are the 3 dB points, correct? Means half power. So let us mark as IM R root by root 2, correct? Corresponding to these 3 dB points, let us mark two frequencies, call as F1 and F2, fine? And this is the center frequency where the resonance is actually occurring, fine? Okay. So this was the thing, and here delta F was F2 minus F1, where you can also mention F2 as F0 plus del F over 2 and F1 as F0 minus del F over. Fine. What is F1 and F2? F1 and F2 are half power frequencies, correct? At the 3 dB point. This is what? This is 3 dB point. Fine. Now the thing is, we supposed to solve this further, and what we can do actually, for the analysis purpose, we can assume that F is equal F naught plus delta F. This thing, correct? So let us start with the first one. So let F is equal F naught plus delta F, where delta F is what? Sorry, it make you make it delta F, right? Just a minute. Delta F. Right? Here, this delta F is actually the small frequency shift from resonance. From resonance point. Correct? Now the thing is, what I want to do here, that I want to find the beta L in terms of distance. Correct? So some relation we need to recall, correct, what we studied actually. So beta is the phase constant actually, and if you write the electrical length, this will be beta L omega upon mu p into L, right? Now you can expand these things and you can write it like this: 2 pi f naught plus del f over mu p into L. Correct. Now if you rearrange all the things, you recall the mu p and all the things, it's suitable form. Correct. So you can write n pi over 2 f naught plus del f 1 upon f. This is one form actually. Fine. Now why we are doing all sort of these things? Because if you remember that expansion, correct? So that expansion carries different sine and cosine term. What expansion I'm talking about? I'm talking about the input impedance, correct? For short-ended transmission line for lambda by 2 case, correct? So we need to expand it, and then we will try to solve these individual terms. That is why this beta L is important here, correct? Now, so finally, I can write as beta L n pi over 2 plus n pi to del f over f naught. This is one thing. Now, if you recall that expansion actually, what we discussed in the last class also, so it was ZIS Z naught J and denominator will be J cos hyperbolic alpha L cos beta L J sine hyperbolic alpha L and sine beta L. This is the expansion. Correct. This is the expansion actually. Remember this term Z naught tan hyperbolic gamma L. Fine. Now the thing is, what we need to do here, we need to solve this cos beta L, sin beta L and all these things. Correct? That is why actually we are much worrying about this term. We want to settle down in terms of the known parameters. And here delta F and F naught is like that. So now one thing, one assumption we also taken, which is alpha L is much, much smaller than 1. Now, keeping this all the facts in mind, and we need to solve this. So first this cos beta L, we need to solve, then sine beta L. So if you solve the cos beta L, keeping this fact, beta L, this value, correct? So you will be getting minus sine n pi by 2 del f over f naught. This is one thing, and this is equivalent to minus n pi by 2 del f by f naught. This is one thing. Okay, now similarly sine beta l, if you solve, this will be cos n pi by 2 del f over f naught is 1. Now assuming here n pi by 2 del f by f naught is less than variable less than to 1. Fine. Now we need to expand. We need to use the expansion here. What is this? No. So this ZIS will become Z naught alpha L into minus n pi by 2 del F over F naught, the first term, plus J into 1 into 1. And about the denominator, this will be 1 into minus n pi by 2 del F over F naught plus J alpha L into 1. Now we need to little bit solve and rearrange this thing. So finally you will be having minus n pi by 2 del f over f naught alpha l plus j divided by j n pi by 2 del f over f naught plus alpha l. Now this whole term here could be neglected, correct? Why? The reason is because this alpha l is very small, correct? So we can ignore it, fine. And this could be written as ZIS is equal Z naught over, the denominator will completely come here, which is alpha l, just rearranging the things. Alpha l plus j n pi by 2 del f over f naught. Fine. This is one thing. What is this? This is ZIS. Now we need to play with this outcome. Now the small mathematics we need to perform, and we can develop a very important relations here. Now, because this is a complex quantity, so we are dealing with the power actually at this higher frequency, so let it convert it like this. ZIS mod square, you can write as Z naught square divided by alpha L square plus n pi by 2 del F over F naught to the whole square. One thing. Now, because we started our assumption like that, f is equal f naught plus del f, because we need to introduce a small shift, okay, then only we can claim some of the things. So let's say at f is equal f naught. So what is this location? This is the location where the maximum amplitude you are going to get at the resonance. It means del f will be 0. So it means ZIS square will provide you the maximum. Fine. So better to write ZIS to the whole square, and let's put it maximum here, and this will be equal to z naught over, sorry, mod of z naught square over alpha l to the whole square. Correct? Because this del f is going to be zero. Correct? We introduce purposefully these things. Try to understand why. Because we can get the journal expression so that we can move around the residence point. Now the thing is, again we are saying that delta f is equal to zero, so we can get the exact idea about the resonance, that what is actually happening. So the thing is, it is quite clear here also that at resonance actually we are getting the maximum value. This is what actually we learned in a last classes as well. Correct? Now what we need to do actually, we can use these two outcomes. What? First, let's say equation number one and equation number two. Just divide. So you will be getting the maximum versus a ZIS, correct? A journal expression, a relations, correct? So you can remove the Z naught. And once you have the maximum value, so you can find it out the other things also. So better to write like this, ZIS whole square over ZIS whole square, and this is maximum, is equal to 1 over what? 1 plus n pi 2 alpha l del f over f naught. Let's say make it in big bracket and square. Correct? So this is one of the very important outcome. Now the thing is, let's try to do some of the things here. Now, if you remember this curve actually, so these were the 2 3 dB points. What do you mean? 3 dB point means half power point. Now the thing is, we need to take care of this half power point, and we can develop some of the relations at this point actually. Sorry. Now what we can do actually, from the equation number two actually, the equation number two, and particularly del f is equal to plus minus del f over two. Correct? What it will indicate? It will indicate that we are going to work at the half power points. Half power point means corresponding frequencies, f1 or f2. Correct? Now from the equation number second that previously we have seen. Now if you introduce these things, correct? So the thing is, like if I draw, it will be much better. So this was the thing. This is what? This is the maximum point at the resonance. So this is what? ZIS square maximum. And this is what? These are the point corresponding to this. This is half power point. So this is ZIS. It means that if you try to develop a relation between these two, how you can write? It is quite simple, that ZIS to the whole square divided by ZIS whole square maximum. So what we will get is 1 by 2. It is quite obvious that 2 times of this will be equal to the ZIS maximum, because right now we are talking about the 3 dB points. Correct? Now the thing is, from this relation we can solve further, and we can write like this, 1 by 2 is equal, these things we already have the expression. So here we are going to develop a relation actually. Correct? So this is 1 plus n pi over 2 alpha l del f over f naught square, complete square, sorry. And here what is delta f? Delta f is actually del f by 2. Please take care of this point. Fine. Now, what we need to do, we need to solve it, correct? And we have to rearrange, correct? Now, if you are rearranging and making delta fs, delta f by 2, so what you can write? N pi by 2 alpha l multiply with del f over 2 f naught to the whole square is equal 1. Now we can further simplify these things. N pi over 2 alpha l del f over 2 f naught is equal 1. Now what we can do further, because beta l is what? N pi by 2. Fine. Beta l is what? N pi by 2. Correct. And what is beta? It's 2 pi by lambda. Fine. For let's say l is n lambda by 4 and beta is 2 pi by lambda. Fine. What we can do actually, we can utilize here and we can develop a very nice relation in terms of beta, alpha and delta f and f naught, which will provide some insight that what is actually happening when this frequency response we are getting for parallel system. Okay, so now if you rearrange these things, you're putting all these things here, so what you're going to get actually, I should mention in a different color, so this will be beta over 2 alpha. I'm talking about these two, this one and this one. I'm going to combine and we are going to get a relation which is this. Okay, fine. Now the thing is, that is okay. This relation and this relation actually providing details actually that how one can relate actually your beta, alpha, delta, f and f naught. And particularly if you recall from the theory, so what you will be getting, that delta f by f naught is nothing but what? It provides you the information about the quality factor. So let's move to the next page. Correct, and we'll start with the fresh. So Q is F naught is del F. We have this definition, if you remember. Now, from the above relation, what was the relation? That beta over 2 alpha delta F over F naught is 1. Now, from this relation, you can settle down the above one, and this will be beta over 2 alpha. So now we have a very nice definition actually of the quality factor, and which is very important when we are talking about the resonators, correct? Now the thing is, the point is actually when we are talking about these transmission lines, correct? So we must recall the practical one, and when we are talking the practical one, so what is happening actually, that it must be the low losses, correct? What we studied. So let us say for low loss lines, so we already derived what is beta. Beta was omega under root LC, and alpha, if you remember, it was half of R under root C by L G under root L by C. Fine. Now just we need to replace these beta and this alpha in this definition, and we can get a very nice formula in terms of the known known lumped parameters, correct? Now let us write down the things. Q will be what? This will be omega under root LC, correct, into, if you place this thing, so denominator will be again LC, So let us make it 2L under root LC, and in denominator you will be getting RC plus, and this will be GL, correct? GL into 2. Fine. If you replace beta and alpha like this, this is the thing. Now if you solve further, so you will be finally having omega L over R plus GL by C. This is what, this is quality factor for low loss transmission lines. This is one thing. Fine. Now the thing is, if I say that the transmission line is well insulated, then what we can say that GL over C is very, very greater, less than to R. Now in that case, the formula will be Q is equal omega L by R. Fine. So now we can find it out the quality factor, which is one of the important thing when we are dealing with the resonator. Fine. Now what is the next, actually what you can do, like we just taken here this lambda by 4 line, correct? Means just I'm repeating all the things, like for L is equal lambda by 4 and transmission line is short circuit, correct? We try to find it out ZIS, and we taken the lambda by 4 case, which was the case B actually. Now what you can do actually as an assignment, you can take L is equal lambda by 2, and we know that we already have seen that this will offer you what, series resonance condition. This will give you the series resonance condition. So you need to fix it ZIS, there's no doubt, correct? And in that case, the frequency response will be like this. Means at the resonance, the ZIS will be minimum. This is just opposite of that. Now what you need to find it out, you need to find the Q when you have the series resonance condition. So this is the assignment you're supposed to perform these things. It's really very important derivation as well, correct? And you can go for other transmission line lengths also, correct? So this is all about, and with this we have completed the wave characteristic on finite transmission line almost. So if you have any questions, we can discuss. Correct, and I'm open for the question answers, please.